Good Friday, everybody. Finally Friday, and we're over here near my parents' farm on a little lot that I cut about once a year, typically, just to kind of keep it from getting completely out of control. So we're gonna take a quick look at what we got and then hop in Big Munchie and do a little bit of mulching. Let's take a look at what we got. All right, I got Big Munchie here getting warmed up. Got the TMC Kinsella on the 120. And so me and my brothers came in here, and my brother-in-law and another friend of ours came in here probably 5 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, back when I had my little John Deere 35, before I was even in business, came in here and cleaned out this lot. Originally my sister was gonna build a house in here, but she ended up not doing that. So this whole thing was just completely wooded. We cleared it out, left this really cool grove of oak trees over here. But it just needs to be cleaned up. I was thinking about burning this pile of stuff at some point, but just never got around to doing it. And I was gonna take it down there. I burned some of it a couple years back, but there's some stumps and stuff in here. We'll grind up a little bit of this pile too and clean it up, and then go on through there and just kind of knock down this grass so it doesn't get too out of control. There's another little pile back there. I pulled some of that out, I think last year, and ground some of it up. So we'll just come through here and make it look nice. Have a little fun with the Big Munch, and gonna unhook the mulcher today. I'm gonna go get a bucket from landscaper Greg. We're gonna be doing some work for the local high school tomorrow, unless it gets rained out, but as far as I know, we're doing that tomorrow. So yep, so let's hop in the machine and get to it. Looking good. Smooth as a baby's butt. Looking really good with this. So was able to get that pile down there, mostly ground down. I didn't think I was gonna be able to, but I actually was able to. There is still some bigger stuff up underneath there in the dirt. I need to bring the mini over here with the bucket. Just scrape, you know, grade that down, get the big, some of the bigger stuff that's still in there out, make a little small pile, finish grinding that off. But at least it's not a big thing of briars and brush in there. So got those couple stumps ground down too. That was fun. Those doggone oak stumps were, the tops were really hard and the bottoms were kind of more soft and rotten. And still got to deal with this pile. It's too tall for me to deal with. There's some big stumps in there. So I have the mini down at the farm, but I don't have the bucket. All I've got is the mulcher and the brush cutter down there. So maybe here in the next couple weeks, I can get over here and we can separate this pile out and get it ground down. Maybe I'll bring the pre-noth over here too. Maybe we could do a comparison. I don't know. But I need to get that ground down. But I've pretty much gotten this almost to the point where I can come in here from now on and just cut this with the zero turn. There's not really any stumps in here. And once I get these piles ground down and they're just mulch, I could probably just come in here with the zero turn from now on and just turn it into grass and just cut grass and not have to bring the big machine down here. Because usually the zero turn is down there at the farm most of the time. Because technically that mower is Kelly's. Well, it's in his name, but the company paid for it. So, all right, well, that looks good. One other thing, I'm gonna unhook the mulcher and I'm gonna show you guys one cool feature on this mulcher that's really kind of unique to it when we unhook it. So I'm gonna take it down to the farm really quick. We're gonna unhook the mulcher because I gotta put the bucket on it and show you guys that really quick. And that'll be it. All right, so I'm gonna unhook the lines. Unhook my electrical connection here. Right there, I'm gonna keep this on here. It's not hurting anything. And I was trying to, there's a pressure release button right here on the ASV. Gotta get, these lines are thick and stiff. That's not a joke. They are kind of a pain to get disconnected. But I will say the pre-noth is even harder to get hooked up than this one. Okay, there we go. All right. I'm gonna try to angle this down so you guys can see what I'm doing, but this mulcher has these legs where it'll sit up, and I'll show you why that's important after I get it hooked up. So, I lost the pin to this one. My bad. But this goes in like that. So, one leg, I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. One thing that the pre-noth doesn't have, and I've had issues with it, because without these legs on the bottom, what'll happen is that skid plate down here is rounded. So when it sits on concrete, like at my shop, like in the back, if I unhook it back there, like the pre-noth, it'll rock, you know. And so when you come up to it to try to hook up, it'll roll forward on you and actually tip over. And Chris over at CC told me, for the pre-nos, you're better just to lay it down with the guard just laying on the ground, and then you can come up and hook up to it like this instead of like this. And so with these legs, this gives it a stable platform. Sorry about my brother's over there sighting his rifle. But this gives this a stable platform to sit right here. And so when I come back to hook up to it, it's gonna be right there. It won't move, it's not gonna rock or roll. and I can hook right back up to it, lift it up, lift the legs back out, and secure them in place and be good to go. Which this one right here, I got to get a new pin for. That was my fault, but still, I just grabbed a pin from the shop and it worked in there fine. So anything will hold through there. You can use a bolt. They come with pins, but I lost one. But yeah, that works great. I really like that. So neat little feature on this mulcher that is really, really handy and convenient. So that is today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I got this thing over my head. The bugs out here are horrible. It hasn't gotten cold enough yet for the bugs to completely go away. But yeah, more stuff to come. I was supposed to go do a 5-acre bush hogging job today, but we got a bunch of rain yesterday, so that's going to be next week. We're doing some work for the local high school tomorrow, helping out the baseball team. I don't know if I'm going to be able to film that or not. That's up in the air, but I'm still going to go help them. That's why I got to get the bucket for this thing. So stay tuned. A lot more stuff to come, and I will check you guys on the next one. Bye, everybody.